We're going to use the angel deck this time to find out your money matters and what matters that's on your mind. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius are first this time. So, as I said that, boom, the Queen of Air, bitch, she appears. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, or possibly dealing with one or someone who acts like one. But the point being is you are cutting through the bullshit. You're seeing, you're knowing, you're believing, and you're also speaking it. And bitch, you ain't playing with nobody. You also see a future trip. You also see a trip in your future as well. Allowing you to get to the completion of a cycle with this Nine of Water here. So something that you're emotional about and emotionally attached to, Scorpio, Cancer, Pisces energy, or somebody who just acts like one. Water sign. Because we do have a third party energy here crossing over the Eight of Fire, my dear. So you have a third party gonna come back around to appear. Leo, Sagittarius energy, Aries is here, but what this really just means is something moving very quickly and passionately back at you. And we did say this was a money read, didn't we, boo? So that could be what's coming back around to you. Why a third party? Well, also could just be simply a third party energy that's affecting your situation, i.e. your money. That's the reading that we're doing, right? So because with the Five of Water here, there is conflicting energy, A, that you have a lot of emotion about, and B, that is going to lead to change. Yes, I'm snapping my finger. That's going to lead to move, change, and manifestation quickly with your emotions. What does it say? Things are not turned out the way you'd hope, not seeing the positive in a situation, crying over spilled milk. Don't do it. With this Three of Fire, abundance, patience, things looking very good. Have patience at this time. Make long-term plans. Okay, and crossing over, that was the Eight, meaning coming back around to you quickly with a lot of movement, passion, and excitement. Events moving at a fast pace. Delays are over. Many things are going to happen at once. So have no fear, my dear. The change is coming for you very near. And oh my God, yes it is, because another number five, another move, change, conflict, manifestation. Conflict that leads to move, change, and manifestation with the Five of Fire quickly, very, very quickly and passionately. You're going to complete your goals. There's a lot of details that are bothering you, but don't worry. And there is some, see, conflict at the bottom, conflict with others. Don't worry about that, though, because you are the star. You are wishing upon a star, and you are going to get what you're wishing for. Also a possible sign of Aquarius here, but that is also you if you are watching or cross our star card watching. And as you already know, you are welcome because you are building your foundation and your stability, and you are very emotional about it, baby. Or building it with a possible Scorpio, Cancer, Pisces. Telling you to wait, exactly, have patience. It's not yet time. Things are being woven. Jump in. What? How the fuck are they going to tell you it's not time, but you always need to jump in? Ain't that too conflicting? Well, you do have conflict right here, don't you? Ain't that too conflicting ideas? No fucking wonder. Andromeda energy. Adventure. Say yes to change. So, say yes to adventure, go on the change, but wait for the right opportunities, time, place, and space for those doors to open up. And as I said, that, holy shit, the portal card, it appears to erupt. So, the doors are going to be opening for you in due time, my dear. Jump through it, and the time will let you know. When it is clear, follow your guides. They will speak to you, and they're always near. Doors are opening, you decide. Rewards, wild card. Wild, and we are wild now, aren't we? Because there's a great severing. This is Mars energy, more conflict. So there's a big conflict here. A big conflict that's leading to a lot of move and change and manifestation. And again, this reading is from now through April. So this conflict leading to a change, leading to a severing, leading to this war Mars-like energy. Because you are a child of the cosmos and you are seeing through it as the courageous peony. This is a flower, but this is also meaning wealth. This is also meaning like union, but also meaning like bashfulness, being shy while you do so. And so I guess the message is you don't need to do that. Multifaceted, unique, natured, let yourself be seen. Exactly like I said, you don't need to be, what the hell is the word? Bashful. Let yourself be seen. You good, boo. Because the Two of Earth is fucking coming at you. There's a lot less something your ass is going to need. A weigh and balance. Don't mind my nails. They fucked up. It's true. Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn energy. Possibly balancing that, but also your money. Too much going on at once. Need to make a decision. Consider more playful approach. That is your solution. because there is a renewal coming to you. Another number two. So that's two twos. I didn't even realize that. But so there's things that you're balancing with your money. And not only are you doing that, but you're doing it very quickly, very quickly, very intensely, very passionately. Leo, Sagittarius, Aries energy, or somebody who just acts like it. You literally have two people here. So possibly balancing between two people. We have a blondie and we have a darkie here. But with that decision is going to come a renewal for you with Archangel Jeremiel and another number two. So those three twos. Review and evaluate a favorable assessment of the facts. Time to move forward in a new direction. The more I talk, the more I realize I haven't drank water in mad long. Because you are having insight. You are seeing through your third eye. Oh, yo, and you know what fucking flew to the ground was the grounding card. But you are needing to ground yourself. God, I keep all want to fall. Sorry, I'm going to fix my leg. Yeah, oh my God, as I'm talking about the grounding, yes, my hip is hurt. My hip is starting to bother me. And what I know about that, the Magician pops up for you as well. And the Queen of Fire to complete your passionate desire. Because you have ego here as the Magician, focusing a little bit too much on your money and your kitchen. Okay, but that's all good because you have all the tools and you're ready to go with the number one that is at the top of the Magician, also a sign of Sagittarius, Gemini. You're ready and you're going with the flow and you're ready to manifest, move, and change and make anything and make it ready. But yo, ego, like we already said, spending a little bit too much time in your material realm. Obviously, this is a money read going in it as the Queen of Fire, being very passionate, very quick, very moving, very fucking intense. Or you are dealing with her, depending on who is watching. But these two keep falling to the ground. So follow your insight, follow your guides, follow your third eye. You also need to ground yourself and your energy. And how you do that is you need to stick your feet in the sand, in the dirt, in the rocks, in the trees, in the ocean, in the sand, if you please. Or the snow. Even in the freeze. The point is you have to actually touch real dirt or pot or real fucking plant. That's where you ground yourself. You do this in the sunrise and the sunset. Don't you forget. No, but the mantra is Lam, L-A-M, Lam, Lam. Oh, pardon me. Cheers. Cheers to these beers. No queers, no fears, no tears. So ground yourself with this red root chakra. If you are having hip issues or anything downward, your knees, your legs, your feet. But hip issues specifically mean there's a travel decision that you need to make. Okay, and I think we did come up with that. And you need to have compassion for yourself and compassion for others in order to get through this and deal with this. Okay, and that is the solution to your problem. And that's the heart chakra, green, A-E-Y-A-M, yum. Because the inner earth is speaking to you and everything is pulsating through. The bigger picture is also seeking through. I said follow your third eye and jump through that portal and follow your dreams because they're speaking to you. All right, so I'm going to stop there. Thank you for watching so much. Bye. Elevate yourself. Please like, share, and subscribe and ring the top bell 3 times if you want to get notified. The lighting is ugly and I have no more boobs left. So thank you for watching. Bye. Aquarius, Libra, and Gemini.